Hi friends, how are you?
Oh, I am fine. If you are fine, I am also fine.
Okay, how did you wrote your English revision test?
I know, you are right very well. Because you are this super student friends, no?
Okay. Will you keep away your all examination tension
and try to listen my lectures very cool. It's very simple topic.
Okay.
Now your mind is immediately ready to listen my lecture on blood groups and importance of blood donation.
Okay.
Okay friends, before going to the topic, I would like to share my an incident with you which I met recently.
Recently, I went to my home. When I'm going to my home for Dasara holiday,
I saw a bus accident. Generally, when we saw this bus accident, there are lots of losses from the victim's body. And there are so many victims are severely injured. I feel so sad. I can't do anything at that time, but with the father of my child, I save it on his life.
Okay?
Generally, now we can see the picture of an accident. Look up here. What are you observing here?
Yeah, it is an accident.
And here, a cyclist is hit by an unknown vehicle, isn't it? So, when we measure this type of accident, large volumes of blood is absorbed in our body. So, blood is very essential to our body. What is the function of blood?
You are very right.
Blood is used for the transportation of oxygen and carbon dioxide in our body. So, without enough amount of blood, how is it possible?
So, loss of large volumes of blood from our body leads to the
defect of several functions of the body, and the person may die.
Did you understand?
Okay. That's why the doctor can prefer blood transfusion to the victims immediately to save the life of the patient.
Do you know blood transfusion?
Yeah, you are saying rightly. Come on. Blood transfusion, no? Blood from one person to another.
Yeah, you are right.
Okay. Now, Tom, what is blood transfusion? What is blood transfusion? Administering blood of one person to another person through the veins is known as blood transfusion. Look at here. What is blood transfusion?
Administering blood of one person to another person through the veins is known as blood transfusion.
Did you understand?
Okay.
Friends, in the early years, the people were thinking that the blood of all human beings is unique. Is it right now?
No.
The blood color of human beings is unique, but not the blood is unique. So, in the year 1900, our scientist, Carl Langsteiner, discovered that the blood of all human beings is not unique.
How?
It means he conducted so many experiments on blood, and he selected different samples of blood from different persons. Then he mixed with each other. And then he found that in some cases, the RBCs which are present in our blood are interrupted and power clumps. In some cases, the RBCs which are in our blood interrupted and power clumps. So, this clumping of blood cells is known as agglutination. What we call friends?
Yeah,
agglutination. Look at here. The clumping of blood cells is known as agglutination. So, what happens if it is occurs in our body?
It means,
if this happens in the blood vessels of a person, these clumps block and prevent the blood flow. The person who is receiving the blood may be dead.
Did you understand?
Okay. Why is it happens in our body?
It means
agglutination of blood is due to the reactions of antigens and antibodies. Agglutination of blood is due to absorbed antigens and antibodies. These antigens and antibodies are second protein molecules which is present on our RBC and plasma. Okay? Look at here, friends. If we assume this is blood, we know very well. What are the components of blood? Yeah, you are right. RBC, WBC, and then? Very good, platelets. You are observing here, these are the RBC. So, this is the membrane of RBC. The antigens for blood groups on the T-cells are the membrane of RBC. Where they are located, friends? Yeah, the antigens for blood groups on the T-cells are the membrane of RBC. And then, next, antibodies. Where they are located? Again, the antibodies for blood groups are located in the plasma of blood. What is plasma? Anyone? Yeah, the fluid portion of blood is known as plasma. This is all. This is plasma of blood. The antibodies for blood is located on the plasma of blood. Antigens are present on the membrane of RBC and antibodies are present in the plasma of blood. Did you understand? Okay. And next, friends, there are two types of antigens. How many types of antigens? Two types of antigens. There are antigen yes. Antigen yes. And antigen B. Okay? So, similarly, there are how many types of antibodies? Very good. There are also two. Two types of antibodies are there. So, there are anti-A. It means antibodies of antigen A. And anti-B. It means there is an antibody for antigen B. How many types of antigens? Two types of antigens. Antigen A and antigen B. How many types of antibodies? Two types. Anti-A, antibody A and antibody B. Okay? Okay, based on these antigen-antibody reactions, our scientist Carl Landsteiner. Friends, have you ever seen the picture of Carl Landsteiner? Okay, don't worry. I will show the picture of him. Look at here. This is the picture of Carl Landsteiner. What he discovered? Yeah, he discovered the blood of all human beings is mercury. Okay, and he also discovered that based on these antigen antibody reactions, he discovered that he classified the blood groups into three main groups. They are A blood group, B blood group, AB blood group. He classified the blood into three main groups, A blood group, B blood group, and AB blood group. Later, the fourth blood group was discovered in the blood. Okay? How many blood groups are there? There are four blood groups have been recognized in this human being. Let us go into discuss about this blood group. Okay? Yeah. Blood group. And how many types of antigen friends? Very good, two types. And where they are located, friends? Excellent. RBC. They are located on RBC. And antibodies, they are located in, very nice, plasma of blood. They are located in plasma of blood. So, we know that how many blood groups? Four blood groups. They are A blood group, B blood group, AB blood group, and O blood group. Okay. The person who are having this A blood group, they have antigen A on their blood vessels and antibody B in their plasma. The person with this A blood group will have antigen A on their blood vessels and antibody B in their plasma. Next blood group, there is a B blood group. The person with this B blood group will have antigen B on their blood vessels and antibody A in their plasma. Next, AB blood group. The person with this A blood group will have both antigen A and antigen B. Both antigen A and antigen B on their blood vessels. But they have no antibodies in their plasma. Did you understand? Okay. Last, finally, this blood group, O blood group. How many of you have in this O blood group? Okay, my blood group is example, O blood group. Okay, the person with this O blood group, they have A, not have either antigen A, I, antigen B. But they have both antibodies, antibody A and antibody B. Did you understand this? Okay, once again, look at your friends. Blood group, how many blood groups? A blood group, B blood group, AB blood group, and O blood group. There are four blood groups. And the persons with this A blood group having A antigen on their red blood cells and B antigen in their plasma. Okay? Next, B blood group. The persons having this B blood group will have antigen B on their RBC and antigen A in their plasma. Next, AB blood group. The persons with this AB blood group will have both antigen A and antigen B on their red blood cells, but they have no antibodies in their plasma. Finally, O blood group. The persons with this O blood group will have no antigens on their RBC, but they have both A antibodies and B antibodies in their plasma. It's very simple to learn. I will give a memory technique to you. Look at here. And here, the antigen is A. That's why this blood group is named as A blood group. Did you understand this technique now? Okay. And here, the antigen is B. That's why this blood group is named as B blood group. And if you look at here, the both antigen A and antigen B are present on the RBC. That's why it is named as both A and B. And here, there is no antigen at all. It means zero. No, more is like a zero. Like this, you can easily remember this question. The guarantee comes for 4 marks in your public exam. So, you can get easily 4 marks in public exam. Okay? Okay. Next. Friends, now we are going to learn about 2 simple terms. 2 simple terms. One is donor and another one is recipient. What is this donor and recipient? It means donor is the person who is donating the blood is known as donor. The person who is donating the blood is known as donor. And what is recipient? It means the patient who is receiving the blood is known as recipient. The patient who is receiving the blood is known as recipient. Did you understand this term? Very good. Now you know who are the donor and recipient and what is the antigen and antibody. Isn't it? So, friends, during the blood transfusion, the antibody of recipient reacts into the antigen of donor. The antibody of recipient reacts into the antigen of donor. Okay, friends, I will show an example. It will understand it better. Look at here. There are two persons named Vimala and Sauvinya. There are two persons named Vimala and Sauvinya. So, on one day, Vimala met with an accident. Okay? Sauvinya is a close friend to Vimala. Then, she was ready to donate blood to Vimala. But when the blood transfusion is done with her? No. Why me? Okay, it is determined that the blood group of Vimala is A and the blood group of Sauvinya is B. So, we know very well what are the antigens present on RBC to A blood group persons friends? Absolutely right, A antigen. And what is the antibody? B antibody, very good. And if you look at here, Sauvinya having B blood group. So, she